We're coming to you live from Tombstone, Arizona. It's sold out Chimera Stadium. This is global warming at its finest, folks. It's a scorching 116 degrees today, but thankfully, it's a dry heat. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers and lots of beers. The Tokyo Terminators take on the Cardinal Sins. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hello again, everybody. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
That's me.
And his mutant hobbit head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
How about you shut the fuck up?
Well played, Jr. Moving on.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And it's first and ten. Big time.
Oh my God, I thought his head was gonna pop off like a big zit.
And it's first and ten. That's a catch for a 4-yard gain. Second down and six. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. They've called a zap attack. The ball carrier better move his ass out of bounds before he... Oh, he was hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. He broke free and has open field in front of him. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. The 10. And he recovers the fumble and runs it back for a defensive score. That's a backbreaker for the offense. The extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
A nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. And it's first and ten. That run is good for 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and one. Third down and 10. And the quarterback calls it and catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play. Huh. I didn't know that was a penalty.
Yeah, these rule changes are ruining the game for him.
Third down and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Third down and never going to happen. You've got to catch that.
Oh, boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
A great throw and a great catch. Oh, and that one's going to hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math. If you don't kill this ref with the attack ref dirty trick, you're going to lose, pal.
You kind of deserve it if you're this dense, Grim.
Well, sometimes the best thing... Defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him. Any field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. Third and 2. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's It's first and 10. Five-yard gain on that pass play.
Hey, look at the coach. He's picking his nose. You know, they shouldn't put that on the Jumbotron. Seems like every time the camera shows him, he's either spitting, picking, grabbing himself in the private. Hey, he should do it all at the same time. Now, that would be worthy of a Jumbotron shot.
And the quarterback, pow, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10.
Oh, man, he really
won. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a get. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and 10. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. Second down and 6. The quarterback had no time to throw, and the defense gets a big sack.
Yeah, man, I was hanging on the kettle now. You know what I have?
Third down and, well, good luck. That's a 6-yard gain on that catch. Man, this coach must have played too many video games. You gotta punt it here. Come on. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
It's first and 10. And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downer's guy than a speed fake grip. He's running from his demons, it's clear.
And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Oh, with the... Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my Dead Mutant bingo card. I only need one more!
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players would catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They had the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down.
And we've got a tight battle here as quarter one comes to an end. And it's first and 10. And that pass is good for about 5 yards. Second down and 5. And the defense gets another pick. Man, rough day. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. And that's another turn. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and 10. Catch on the play.
Every little bit counts. Those 3 yarders might grow up to be somebody one day.
Second down and 7. He was starting. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
Third and 4. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he put all of his foot into that one. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball is down.
And it's first and 10. Trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's first and 10. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10. Does the QB know which team he's on? Man, what a hit that was. And the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And it's first and 10. At this point, with multiple, brought him to a dead stop, literally. Oh, man. First and 10. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. He could go all the way. And he bursts into the end zone for the score. What a run. Left and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last 2 runners for this outman.
You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! Watch out, the Royals. Anymore, Bricks.
My dad used to cut our hair with Oz. That was the first time I lost my ear. The ear fairy gave me a quarter for it, though. Hey, that was a lot for an ear back then, let me tell you.
Second down and two. Like to have your teeth removed without Novacare. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Now, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
It was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
And that'll be second and eight to go. They weren't even on the same page on that play. Third down and eight. And like Bricks' balls, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down. Kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run. Killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And it's first and ten. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Bricks' mom decided to move back in with us.
Second down and two. First down. And it's 2 minutes left in the half.
I can't wait till the halftime show.
And it's first and ten. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... never mind. Yes, Brick, he will. Second down and ten.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Ah, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy!
And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
Second down and 10. Oh, what a brutal hit! They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
And it's first and 10. Sandwich. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the NFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
First down and 6. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Well, he made the pass, but then a slap in the face by the defense.
Oh, that's me in the hotel bar every night.
Hey, your opening line needs work.
Why?
Really? What's a pretty girl?
And that'll be their final timeout. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. That would have been a disappointing run. It's even a worse throw. Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And the ball is lateral to his teammate. We're talking street ball. And that'll be a first down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old... The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
First and 10. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Oh, with a punishing hit! With the vision, the Cardinals fans ruthlessly destroy the opposition and win by forfeit. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. The alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about
if you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say.